All right, here we go. It says name the ray. The ray always starts at the end point. Some kids are going to put the arrow this way. It starts at B, but that's wrong. The arrow always points this way, regardless. The direction comes from the letters. You're starting at B, and you're going out to A. So it's ray BA. If you say ray AB, it would look like this. And we don't want ray AB, we want ray BA. Again, this is called the end point. End meaning it stops. Next. Name the angle three ways. Justin, towards the end of the period. Ladies. All right, up here it says name it three ways. You could just say angle X from the vertex. That's one. Or you could say angle AXB going this way. Or you could say angle BXA. But understand that the vertex is always in the middle. That's where it pivots. Find perimeter and area. Well, area is just going to be 8 times 2. Length times width. So 8 times 2. So put area equals 16 square something. Square units. Perimeter is adding them all up. So it's 2 plus 2 is 4. 8 and 8 is 16. 16 and 4 is 20. So that's going to be 20 feet. Understand that perimeter is one dimension. Area is two dimension. Any questions on number 3? Number 4 is a kite. This one wants the perimeter, however. So this is going to be 20. And this one's going to be 30. Perimeter, you're going to add it up and get 60 plus 40. So you're going to put 100 feet is the perimeter. This is one dimension. You don't need to put the 1. Circumference and area. Well, circumference is pi times diameter. So 3.14. And the diameter is not 4. The diameter is 2 of those is 8. Area is pi. Radius squared. So you're going to do 4 times 4. Make sure you understand the difference between radius and diameter is the whole thing. Radius is the little one. Explain in your own words. Circumference is the distance around a circle. I'm going to say it again. The distance around a circle is circumference. If you go around the dome over there in St. Pete a few times, you're doing circumference. Area would be the inside, the grass, or the cheese and sauce of a pizza. The crust would be circumference. All right, this one right here, perimeter, all you do is just add all this up. It was in the book. It just seems real easy. Just add it up. Area, let's see what we're doing here. Okay. On this diagram right here, listen to me carefully on this one. This one is basically a big rectangle plus a quarter of a circle. So to get the area, you're going to take this 7 times 5 would be the rectangle. So 7 times 5 is the rectangle plus a quarter of a circle. So pi radius squared is the whole circle, but you only want 1/4 of it. 1/4 of a circle. So you're going to take 3.14. The radius is 3. So it's going to be 3 times 3 divided by 4 plus 35. I'm going to say that again. 3 times 3 times this, pi, divided by 4 plus 35. That would be the area of the entire image. Any questions on the concept of area? Perimeter. Look up here and listen. It's going to be on video tonight, but look here. Perimeter. Let's say I start here. I go up 5. I go over 7 because it's the same. I go down 2. And then I hit the curve, which we'll talk about in a second. So plus the curve, plus another 7. So I got to get this curve. The curve is 1/4 of a whole circumference. So you're going to take pi times diameter divided by 4 would be the curve. I'm going to say that again. Pi times diameter divided by 4. Now the diameter is not 3, guys. The diameter of the circle would be 6. 3 plus 3 would be 6. So it's going to be 3.14 times 6 divided by 4 is the curve plus all these other little pieces. Any questions on the concept of perimeter or distance around that image? All right, if you understood it, like I said, it's going to be on video. The bullet problem is on there as well, so watch carefully. I'm going to do area first. Area is going to be 5 times 8 plus half a circle. The whole circle is pi radius squared, but you only want half of it. You know what pi is. Now look, the radius... The radius is not 5. 5 is the diameter. So you want half of that. So it's going to be 2.5 times 2.5 divided by 2 plus 40. Any questions on the concept of what I said? It's half, Jenny, half of a circle. Now here goes the distance around. So look up. If I start here, I go 8. So 8 plus the curve, which we'll talk about in a second, plus another 8, and then plus 5, and then I'm back where I started. Now let's talk about the curve. The whole distance around the circle is called circumference. So that's pi times diameter. We don't want the whole thing, so you divide by 2. In this case, the diameter is 5. So put 3.14. The diameter is 5. The only way I can see you missing this is by confusing radius and diameter. Any questions on what I did? I would multiply, divide, plus, Travis, plus, and plus. Any questions on how to get around this bullet? All right, let's go to 11. It says, find the outer annular, this piece here. You're going to take the big circle, so it's going to be pi radius squared minus the little circle, pi radius squared. Well, pi, you know, the radius of the big circle is 8, so it's going to be 8 times 8 minus pi. In the little circle, the radius is 4. So you're going to do 4 times 4. So you're going to get an answer on your calculator. Write it down. You're going to get an answer and subtract those two, and you get the outer annular. Any questions on the outer annular? It says, how much longer is the outer one compared to the inner one? In other words, if you walk around the outer circle, if I walk around the outer circle, how much longer is it compared to walking around the little circle? Well, The big circle is going to be pi times diameter. The little circle is going to be pi times diameter. So use 3.14. Make sure you use the diameter. So if this thing is 8, then the diameter is 16. Are you with me right here? Look up at the screen now. So I got pi, and then the diameter of the little one, if this is 4, then the diameter would be 8. I would think it's twice as big, but you'll know it when you figure it out. Any questions on number 11? I did the area, big minus small, and I did the distance around the circles. Big circle minus little circle. All right, 11, I think that takes care of that. Let's go to part 2, and we'll wrap this thing up. A trapezoid. By now, you should have it memorized. It's 1/2 the height. In this case, the height is 5. Times the sum of the two bases. So it's 11 plus 6. So on your calculator, you would do 17 times 5. And then divide by 2. Any questions on how to do the area of a trapezoid? Your formula, in case you want to write it down, is 1/2 the height times the sum of the two bases. Number 2 is a triangle. A triangle is 1/2 the base times height. Look up here. You see this box? It touches the 4, which is your height, and it touches the 5. Not really, but that's what you're going to say because it's down here. So the base is 5. And the height is 4. So it's going to be 5 times 4, which is 20, divided by 2 is 10. Any questions on how to do area of the triangle? Focus on the box. Okay, we did the trapezoid, we did the triangle. Look at the kite. This cross member is 8 and 8. So it's 16. Diagonal times... this diagonal is the same as this outer piece, so 20 divided by 2. I'm going to say it again. Diagonal times diagonal divided by 2. Same formula for a rhombus. This, however, is a parallelogram. All it is base times height. Look at the box. 10 times 8. Base times height. I'm going to say it again. Do not take half of that. Half is for the trapezoids, triangles, kites, rhombuses, but not a parallelogram. This is like a rectangle, base times height. It's a parallelogram. All right, last one, maybe. Watch what I do. There's a formula from geometry, but I'm going to go ahead and make a triangle. A bunch of triangles, 6 of them to be exact. So I'm going to have 6 triangles. Copy that down. 6 triangles. If I find the area of one, I multiply by 6. Well, the base of this thing is 8. So I do 1/2 of 8. The height of the triangle looks like 9 right here. The height of the triangle is 9. So I do 9 times 8, 72, divided by 2, 36, and then 36 times 6, whatever that is, would be the answer. Any questions on that regular hexagon? All right, we're just about done. The last one, we got 2 more. You got to measure this. Now look. If you want to bring your own protractor, that's fine, but watch. You got to make this thing longer. So you use a straight edge would be better. You drop the protractor on here, and I already taught you how to do that. You just measure from here to here. So you got to expand that little bitty angle. Some of you did it in the book, and that was okay, but technically... piece of paper would have been better. So look here. Pythagorean's theorem is leg squared plus leg squared equals hypotenuse squared. The arrow points to the hypotenuse. So it's going to be x squared plus 16 equals 64. I'm almost done. So now at this point, I want to draw my line, subtract 16, and then hit the square root button one time. So 64 minus 16 is going to give me 48. And the answer is going to be the square root of 48, which equals 2.6 approximately. Any questions on how to do Pythagorean's theorem? Okay, this is your test. It's going to be online tonight. You can rework it as much as you want. I am going to change the numbers. As far as the formulas, I'll give them to you if you need.